Welcome to all of you. My name is Yogendra Singh Tomar. I am your online instructor. So today I am going to teach you about a very important and interesting topic. The topic name is AWS regions and availability zones. So let us understand. AWS is a global cloud service provider and therefore it has many data centers all around the world. Regions are the geographical locations in which AWS data centers are located. So let us understand clearly with the help of a paintbrush. So our cloud service provider, as we are discussing here, which is AWS. So this AWS cloud service provider have many regions like Mumbai, and this Mumbai region will contain its data centers, AWS data centers. So every region almost have 2, 3 or 6 data centers. Data center 1, data center 2, data center 3. So like the Mumbai regions, we can have other regions also, and the other regions also will have their data centers. So let's say we have another region called as Tokyo. So Tokyo region will have multiple data centers. Let's say this is data center 1, data center 2 and data center 3. So regions, here we mean to say that regions are the geographical locations in which AWS data centers are located. So as we have seen in this example, in India we have Mumbai region. So Mumbai region in which AWS data centers are located. Data center 1, data center 2, data center 3. And Tokyo region, in the Tokyo region we have data center 1, data center 2 and data center 3. So these data centers inside the AWS regions will be called as availability zones. So let us move on towards the slide again. As you can see in this picture, we have blue dots and orange dots. Blue dots represents the existing data centers in the global world, in this world, which are already existing. But we have some orange dots also. Orange dot means the data centers which are planning to place in futures. So orange dots are the future data centers which is not existing, but the AWS have a plan to start new data centers in future. Regions are each of them a set of data centers. So regions are the set of the data centers. We can say that's the it's a group of data centers. So as you have seen in the previous example, in the Mumbai we have 3 data centers. Three data centers means availability zone 1, availability zone 2, availability zone 3. And in the Tokyo region we have availability zone 1, availability zone 2, availability zone 3. In the Tokyo region or the geographical location of Tokyo, we have also 3 data centers. The naming conventions for the regions are usually it can be US East 1. US stands for the data centers which are located in United States. So US, the name, it sounds like that this data centers, this region belongs to United States. So EU is a prefix of Europe. So we can easily understand that the EU is a data center or the region which belongs to Europe. And when you go into the AWS console, when you will click on the regions, then you will find many regions. So if I will go to the console, so in order to see the console, we have to go to the web browser. In the web browser, we need to type aws.amazon.com. So we can see sign into the console option is displaying in front of us. So click on sign into the console. So here it is asking to enter the user ID and password. So root user is already selected, so we need to enter the email address through which we have registered the free tier subscription. Now we need to click on next. Now enter the password. Now we got successfully login inside the AWS web-based console. Now here you can see this is the dashboard of the AWS management console. So as you can see, besides my name, here it is showing the region Mumbai. So Mumbai region is already selected. Now we are inside the Mumbai region. So when we will click on the triangle besides the Mumbai region, we can see we have various regions or the geographical regions in which the AWS data centers are located. So we have US East, North Virginia, US East 1, US East Ohio, US West North California, and like the same way, similarly, Asia Pacific Hong Kong, Asia Pacific Mumbai, Asia Pacific Seoul, etc. So you can see the list of the various regions in which AWS data centers are located. Now let us go to the slides again. Regions code is just a way for us to identify the region quickly. So as we understood that every region will have some region code. For example, for the US regions, the prefix is US. For the Europe regions, the prefix is EU. Regions corresponds to a geographical location for that region. So it means to say that region is a geographical location in which AWS data centers are located. So region is a cluster of data centers. Cluster of data centers means that region, in a one region there will be more than one data centers. Let's say we have Mumbai region, so inside the Mumbai region we have multiple data centers. So we have data center 1, data center A, data center B, and data center C. So we have 3 data centers inside the Mumbai region. So every data center inside a particular region will be called as availability zones. So in short, we can say it is AZ, AZ. Similarly, if we have Tokyo region, inside the Tokyo region we can have multiple data centers, data center A, data center B, and data center C. So all these data centers will be called as availability zones. So we can say that in Mumbai we have availability zone A, means data center 1 inside the Mumbai region, data center A inside the Mumbai region, availability zone B means data center B inside the Mumbai region, availability zone C means data center C inside the Mumbai region. So let us move on towards the slide. Region is a cluster of data center. Cluster of the data center means we have one Mumbai region. Inside the Mumbai region we have 3 data centers, and these 3 data centers are located inside a single region, Mumbai. So that's why we are calling the summation of all the availability zone is a cluster of Mumbai data centers. Now we will discuss about availability zones. Each single data center is called as availability zone. Each region can have multiple or many availability zones, and I also refer to them as AZ or AZ. AZ for availability zones. So usually it's going to be 3 AZ per region. Sometimes you will see 2 and sometimes you will see 6. It means to say that every region will have the certain number or specific number of availability zones or data centers. So we can say availability zone is the another name of a data center. So we have some regions like US North Virginia, in which we have 6 data centers, means 6 availability zones. Example for the region AP Southeast 2, which represents the Sydney region. Then we are going to have 3 AZ. The first one is AP Southeast 2A. The second one is AP Southeast 2B. And finally, the third one is AP Southeast 2C. We can see here the regions are with a number, and the AZ or availability zones are with a letter A, B, C, D, E, F. As you can see here, AP Southeast 2. It means to say that up to here is representing the region, and afterwards A is a data center or the availability zone. It means the region is Sydney, and inside the Sydney region we have the availability zone A. And here, up to here, we can say that the region is Sydney, and inside the Sydney region we have the availability zone B. Up to here we have region Sydney, inside the Sydney region we have data center or availability zone C. So I hope so you understood how we can discriminate the difference in between the region and availability zones. So availability zones represented by alphabet, and region is represented by the number, like as you can see AP south is 2, so 2 is a number. Networking and connectivity. So networking and connectivity means to say that every data center or every availability zone or each availability zone is separate or located separately from the another availability zone. Every availability zone is located far. So AZ or availability zone are with the A, B, C, D, E, F, as you understood very well, right? Now move on to the next point. And each data center will have redundant power, networking and connectivity. So every data center or each single data center will have the redundant power, networking and connectivity. So let us understand what does it mean. Let's go to the paintbrush. Let's say we have Mumbai region. Inside the Mumbai region we have 3 availability zones, means 3 data centers. So availability zone A, availability zone B, availability zone C. So it means to say that we have 3 availability zone or 3 data centers, but they are located inside the same region. So each data center or availability zone will have multiple connections of network, right? So a data center is communicating or connecting with the B and C, right? So A is not connecting only with the one single network cable, right? It is not connected through the one network connection. It can have the two network connection. If one network connection will get fail, then second is connecting still to the data center from A to C, right? So whatever the networking connections inside the A data center will be different, right? And whatever the network connection networking inside the B, it will be different. And whatever the network inside the C data center or the C availability zone will be different. Inside a particular availability zone we will have the multiple servers. Suppose server 1, server 2, server 3, server 4, server 5, right? We can have the multiple storage also, okay? So multiple network also, right? So C is having the different network, different storage, and B will have the different network and different storage, and A will have the different network and different storage. So every availability zone will have their own storage and on network, so they are independent, but still they are communicating with each other. They are synchronizing to each other, means A is getting sync with the B and getting sync with the C, right? In order to provide the high availability of the information, think about that in future. In future, some tragedy will happen and a data center will be completely crash. But we have no need to worry about that, because the replica of the A is still existing in the B, and the B is located far from the A data center, and C also located far from the A data center. So that's why each data center is syncing with the another corresponding data center within a same region. So A is syncing with B and C, B is syncing with the A and C is syncing with the A and B. So I hope so you understood this thing. AWS availability zones are connected with one another with high bandwidth, ultra low latency networking. So we have a connectivity between all the availability zone in a regions. As I told you, A is syncing its information to the B and C data centers, right? A availability zone is syncing its information with the B and C availability zone in order to overcome from the disaster, because the disaster can be uncertain due to the earthquake or heavy flood or tsunami, right? So each availability zone is located separately and located far but inside the same region in order to avoid the disaster. So it is best if you pick a region that is close to you. Suppose I am located inside the India, right? If I am located inside India, let's say I am located inside India, so inside the India we have data center Mumbai, right? We have Mumbai region, and the Mumbai region will have various availability zone A, B and C. So instead of keeping my resources in the other region, maybe US, so I will not prefer to keep my IT resources in the US, because the US is very far. So it will affect the speed. It will take the more latency for accessing my resources if my resources will be in US. So I will prefer to keep my resources inside my very nearest region. So my very nearest region will be Mumbai. I hope so what I want to say you understood. Some AWS services are region wise and some are global. What does it mean? It means to say that some of the AWS services will be available in the multiple regions. Think about EC2. EC2 is a service. So EC2 service will be available in the Mumbai region. It will be available in the US North Virginia region. It will be available in the Tokyo region, right? But some of the services like IAM, Identity and Access Management Service. So this service is not located inside a particular region. So the scope of this service is global, right? So let us see on the portal. So inside the portal, if you will see EC2, so EC2 service is available inside the Mumbai region. Right now we have already selected Mumbai. If you'll go to North Virginia, US East, Now we are going to click on it. You can see EC2 service is available here. So in every region there is a separate EC2 service, right? It means to say that if we have AWS data center, AWS in the for AWS we have two regions. Number one is Tokyo, okay, and another region is Mumbai, right? So in the Tokyo region, if we have EC2 service, if the EC2 service is here, right, and according to the EC2 service, what we have created one EC2 instance, web server instance. So EC2 instance in the other cloud service provider like the Microsoft Azure will be called as virtual machine. So we want to understand that web server is a virtual machine or the EC2 instance that we have created inside the Tokyo region. So inside the Tokyo region we have created. So when we will switch on to the Mumbai region, in the Mumbai region, do you think that web server instance will be available? The answer is no. It will not get sync inside the Mumbai region. If you want to create EC2 instance in the Mumbai region, then we need to switch to the Mumbai region and we have to proceed the steps for creating the new EC2 instance. It means every EC2 instance is a service which is located inside the Tokyo region, and EC2 instance separately as a service located also inside the Mumbai region, right? So whatever the data of the EC2 instance will store, data of the EC2 instance will store inside the Mumbai region, it will remain existing in the Mumbai region. It will not sync into the Tokyo region, and whatever the data of the EC2 instance will be remain in Tokyo. It will not get sync into the Mumbai region, right? So EC2 instance, whatever the EC2 instances you will create in the Tokyo region, it will be remain in the Tokyo. You can see after switching inside the Tokyo region, it will not be available in the Mumbai region, and whatever the EC2 instances you will create inside the Mumbai region, it will remain only inside the Mumbai region. You cannot see in the Tokyo region. So because the EC2 instance is a region-wise service. Now let's go to the portal. You can see here EC2 region, EC2 service is available in the North Virginia region also, and you can see in the Mumbai region also. So this service is region-wise service. So if you will see the IAM service, so let's click on the IAM. So now you can see we are inside the IAM dashboard. So you can see that if you will see the regions, all the regions are disabled because it is not a region wise service. IAM is not a region wise service. It is a global service. So you know what is the purpose of the IAM, Identity Access Management Service. It is used for मैनेजमेंट ऑफ आइडेंटिटीज, आइडेंटिटीज का इज आर द यूजर्स, यूजर ऑब्जेक्ट्स, ग्रुप्स, एंड वी कैन डिफाइन द सिक्योरिटी दैट विच यूजर कैन एक्सेस वट रिसोर्स. सो वी विल डिस्कस लेटर इन द अनदर टॉपिक ऑफ आई ए एम, बट आवर पर्पज हेयर वॉन्ट टू से that what are the region wise service and what are the global services. Global services does not contain inside a particular region. Example is IAM. So IAM is a service which is global. The region is not the region, all the regions are disabled. So let's go to the slides. So now let's go to the web portal of the AWS and let's see the global infrastructure. So let's go to the another tab, AWS Global Infrastructure. So if you'll type AWS Global Infrastructure, it will display us the very important information regarding the regions and availability zones. So you can see here 24 launched regions we have and 77 availability zones. And if you'll scroll down a little bit, so you can see AWS Global Infrastructure map is displaying. You can see some of the circles are highlighted with blue circle, and like Europe, what it is showing, it is showing launched 2018. It means to say that the data center inside this region means it is showing Europe Stockholm. It is launched in the year 2018 and it has three availability zones. Let's move on to the another one, Ireland. So it is showing that the AWS data center region was launched in the year 2007 and it is also having the three availability zones. Three availability zones means the three data centers. And let's randomly see another one, Cape Town. And the Cape Town also have the region, AWS region, which is already launched, but it was launched in the year 2020 and it has three availability zones. Now let's see the red circle, the red highlighted circle, it is showing Jakarta. So Jakarta, I think so, it is the capital of Indonesia, and in Indonesia there is no data center, there is no AWS data center. So it is showing coming soon means the AWS is planning to launch its new data centers inside the Jakarta. So I hope so you understood how we can see where the AWS regions are already existing and in which regions or the countries the AWS is planning to start or to construct the new data centers. So if we will see here, we have 24 launch regions and 77 availability zones. So let's see the other things. Let's click on regions and availability zones. Okay. So you can see we have various regions as a map we can see. So North America is also one of the regions, South America, Europe, Middle East, Africa, Asia Pacific, these are the regions, and in which we have AWS availability zones or the data centers and edge networks. So edge networks, what are the edge networks, we will understand later. So now if we'll click on sustainability, so here you can see some more information. So if you click on AWS regional services, so inside the AWS regional services in the left corner we have an option region table. So if you click on the region table, you can see that which region is containing which service. So if we have already selected US East North Virginia, so whatever the services are available inside the North Virginia region, we can see here what are the services are available, like the AWS data sync service is available, AWS dplan service is available, AWS directory service is also available, right? Many more services are available. So whatever the total number of services are available inside the North Virginia Virginia region, we can see all the services, right? If you want to find out what are the services which are located inside the Mumbai region, Asia Pacific Mumbai region, so we need to select Mumbai, and whatever the services are available inside the Asia Pacific Mumbai region, it will show the list of all the services. We can, the purpose to show you this table, that to make you understand, to make you understand the new thing, that every service is not available inside every region, right? Let's say we have a region name is Mumbai. Another region we have Tokyo. So these are the two different regions of AWS. Let's say we have the service A. The service A, which is present inside the Mumbai region, but maybe it is possible the service A is not present inside the Tokyo region. Let's say we have service B, and service B is present inside the Tokyo region, but the same service, service B, maybe it is not available inside the Mumbai region, right? So some services may be available in a particular region and some service may be not available in the particular region. So if you want that particular service which is not available inside your nearest region data center, then you can move on to the other, then you can move on to the other region and try to find out that in which region that your required service will be available. आई होप सो यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाट आई वांटेड टू से. थैंक यू वेरी मच.